Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the last class we saw what is prime factors, what is prime factorization, right, and how to find HCF using prime factorization method. Today what we'll do is we'll learn how to find LCM using prime factorization and common division method. Okay, so let's start with a quick revision of what we have done yesterday, and then we'll do LCM using prime factorization and common division method. So first of all, what are prime factors? Prime factors are nothing but they are prime number factors of a given number. What are prime numbers? Prime numbers are nothing but numbers which have only two factors, one and itself, correct? So prime factors are prime number factors of the given numbers. So now what is prime factorization? Factorizing a number such that it's a product of its prime factors is called as prime factorization. So we saw different examples as to how to prime factorize a number, correct? So how to find factors using prime factorization, that is by division method. So we know different problems, then we saw how to find HCF. So how you'll find HCF? HCF will be the product of common prime factors. So if you see 28 and 42, which are the common prime factors here? So we have 1, 2 common and 1, 7 common. So HCF of 28 and 42 will be 2 into 7, 14. Then we completed exercise 4.3, right? So we solved various problems on prime factorization and HCF. Now what we are going to study is we are going to study prime factorization and common division method of finding LCM. So we know how to find LCM of two numbers by listing multiples of both the numbers, then by finding the common multiples, and then in from those common multiples identifying the lowest common multiple, right? So but when the numbers are large, okay, when you have to find LCM of large numbers, this listing methods becomes difficult. So in such cases, we use something called prime factorization method or the common division method. Okay, so we'll see how to find LCM using these two methods. First, by prime factorization method. We have learned how to do prime factorization, right? So here they have told find the LCM of 12, 20 and 30. First, what I'll do, I'll find the prime factors for 12. So that is by common, so that is by division method. So we know that 2 6 are 12. So we'll divide 12 by 2 first, we'll get 6. Then we'll divide 6 by 2 again, we get 3. Now we know 3 1s are 3. So what is the prime factors for 12? It is 2 into 2 into 3. Then 20. 2 10s are 20. Okay. Then 2 5s are 10 and 5 1s are 5. Then for 30, we know that 30 divided by 2 is 15. 3 5s are 15 and 5 1s are 5. So you have to keep dividing the given number by prime numbers. Okay. So 30, 20 is 2 into 2 into 5 and 30 is 2 into 3 into 5. Okay, now to find LCM, you have to find the maximum number of times each prime factor occurs. Okay, so first we'll take 2. What is the maximum number of times 2 occurs for a number as prime factors, right? So if you see in 12, 2 occurs 2 times, and in 20 also 2 occurs 2 times, in 30 2 occurs once. So here you'll now you have to write maximum number of time the prime factor occurs. So maximum number of time 2 is occurring is 2. Okay, so 2 occurs 2 times, so 2 into 2. Then 3. 3 occurs once in 12, doesn't come in 20, and it occurs 1 in 30. So 3 occurs only once in 12 and 30. Then 5 occurs once in 20 and in 30. So LCM is the product of all of this, that is 2 into 2 into 3 into 5, which is 60. So LCM of 12, 20 and 30 is 60. Okay, so we'll solve few more questions, then you'll understand how to do it. Then prime factorize 35 and 56. Find their LCM and HCF. Okay, so first we'll prime factorize 35. 5 sevens are 35. Then 7 ones are 7. So 35 is 5 into 7. Then 56. 2 28s are 56. Then 2 14s are 28. 2 7s are 14 and 7 1s are 7. So 56 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 7. Okay, now to find LCM, you know, you have to find how many times the prime factor occurs. Maximum number of time the prime factor occurs. Correct? So 2. Now 2 doesn't occur in 35 at all. In 56, it comes 3 times. So we'll write 2 into 2 into 2. Then what about 5? 5 comes once in 35 and only in 35. So into 5. Then 7 comes once in 35 and once in 56. So into 7. So 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 into 7, which is 280. Now LCM, you know how to find the LCM, right? So you have to write only the prime factor that is common for both 35 and 56. So here only 7 is common for 35 and 56. So HCF of 35 and 56 is 7. Okay, LCM is 280 and HCF is 7. Now, coming to third example. Find the LCM of 12 and 30 by common division method. So you all know what is division method, right? How to prime factorize by division method. Now we'll learn how to prime factorize using common division method. Okay, so 12, 30. Now, what we were doing, we were separately dividing two numbers. Here, we'll divide it together. So we'll write 12 and 30 like this. Now we know 2 6s are 12. So we'll write 6 here. Then 30 divided by 2 is 15. That is 2 15s are 30. Now here 6 can be divided by 2 again. So we'll divide it by 2. 2 3s are 6. But we cannot divide 15 by 2. So what we'll do, we'll bring down 15 as it is. Okay. We'll bring it down as it is. Now here we have 3 and 15. We know that 3 1s are 3 and 3 5s are 15. Correct? So this now, this 1, what you do, you'll bring it down as it is. Then we'll do 5 1s are 5. Okay, so whenever you can divide a number, you divide it. If not, you bring it down and then you complete the division for that number later. So your LCM, what you'll write, you'll just write it as a product of these divisors. So 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. So LCM of 12 and 30 is 60. Okay, so here next one, find the LCM of 14, 35 and 105. Okay, so 14, 35 and 105, we'll write it together like this. Now if you see 35 and 105 is divisible by 5. So we'll start dividing by 5 first. But 14 is not divisible by 5. So we'll bring down 14 as it is and keep it. Then 5 7s is 35, right? So we'll write 7 here. Then 5 2s are 10. 5 2s are 10 and 5 1s are 5. Okay, so 21. Now 14, 7 and 21 are all divisible by 7. So 7 2s are 14. 7 1s are 7. 7 3s are 21. Now here you have 2 and 3. Both are prime numbers. So what you'll do first, you can either divide by 2 or 3. So 2 1s are 2. This one you'll bring down as it is. Then this 3 you'll bring down as it is. Now you'll divide by 3. These both the ones you bring down as it is. Then 3 1s are 3. Okay. So here LCM will be 5 into 7 into 2 into 3. That is 210. So LCM of 14, 35 and 105 is 210. Okay, so this is how you find LCM by prime factorization method or common division method. Now we'll see solve a few problems that are there in your textbook. So exercise 4.4, page number 147. Okay, so question 1, 2 and 3. First, we'll start with question number 1. Find the LCM by prime factorization. So, we have to do prime factorization and find the LCM of the given numbers. So, first one is 4, 6. So, let's do that first. Okay, so 4 comma 6, first what we'll do, first we'll prime factorize 4. Okay, so 2 2s are 4, then 2 1s are 2. So 4 is 2 into 2. Then what about 6? 2 3s are 6 and 3 1s are 3. So 6 is 2 into 3. So LCM here will be, now 2 occurs 2 times in 4 and 1 time in 6. So maximum it is occurring 2 times. So we'll write 2 into 2 and 3 occurs only once. So into 3. So 2 into 2 into 3 is 12. Okay, so next one, so LCM of 4 and 6 is 12. Now, question B, 3 and 9. Now, if you see here, 3 already is a prime number, correct? So, you cannot write it as a product of prime numbers. So, 3 prime factorization will be 3 itself. Then, coming to 9, 3 3s are 9 and 3 1s are 3. So, 9 is 3 into 3. Now here 3 is occurring maximum 2 times in 9. So LCM will be 3 into 3, 9. Okay. Then 8 and 12. So first we'll prime factorize 8. Here 2 4s are 8. Then 2 2s are 4. And 2 1s are 2. So 8 is 2 into 2 into 2. Then coming to 12. 2 6s are 12. Then 2 3s are 6 and 3 1s are 3. Okay, so here 2 is occurring how many times maximum? It is maximum occurring 3 times in 8, right? So it will be 2 into 2 into 2 and 3 occurs only 1 time. So into 3, that is 24. So LCM of 8 and 12 is 24. Now there's one more question, D question, that is 15 and 25. Try to do that for your homework. Okay, so try to do find LCM of 15 and 25 for homework. I'll tell you all the answer now. Okay, so you all can see if you all are right and wrong. So answer for 15 and 25, that is LCM of 15 and 25 is 75. Now coming to question 2, prime factorize, hence find LCM and HCF. So you have to prime factorize and find both LCM and HCF. So here 9 and 12. So first we just now did 1 for 9, right? So 3 3s are 9 and 3 1s are 3. So 9 is 3 into 3. Then 12. So here 12, now we have 2 6s are 12. Then 2 3s are 6 and 3 1s are 3. So now here 2 occurs maximum 2 times, right? So 2 into 2 and 3 occurs maximum 2 times in 9, 3 into 3. So LCM is 2 into 2 into 3 into 3, which is 36. Okay, that will be 36. Then HCF, we have to find common prime factors, right? So here we have only 1, 3 as a common prime factor. So HCF of 9 and 12 will be 3. Okay, HCF of 9 and 12 is 3. And coming to the next one, B1, 14 and 21. So first we'll prime factorize 14. Now we know 2 7s are 14, right? So we'll write 7 here. Then 7 1s are 7. So 14 is 2 into 7. Then 21. 3 7s are 21 and 7 1s are is 7. So 21 is equal to 3 into 7. So LCM. So for LCM now here, 2 is occurring 1 time. So we'll write 2, 3 occurs 1 time and 7 occurs maximum 1 time. So LCM will be 2 into 3 into 7, which is 42. Okay, then HCF. Now HCF, which are the common factors for both 14 and 21? We have only 7 as a common factor. So HCF for 14 and 21 is 7. Alright, then question number C, 16 and 20. Now here 16, first you'll prime factorize it as 2 8s are 16, then 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4 and 2 1s are 2. So 16 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Then coming to 20, 2 10s are 20, then 2 5s are 10 and 5 1s are 5. So here 2 occurs maximum how many times in 16 and 20? 2 occurs maximum 4 times. Okay, and 20 occurs maximum how many times? Sorry, 5. 5 occurs once. So LCM will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 5. So when you multiply, you'll get 80. Okay, now coming to HCF. Now HCF, common prime factors are 1, 2 and 2, 2. So 2 into 2. So HCF of 16 and 20 is 4. Okay, HCF is 4. So this was question 2. Now here question 2, D8 and 16, you'll have to try to do it for your homework. Okay, so try to do question D for your homework. Okay, now coming to question number 3. Find LCM by common division method. Okay, so finding LCF by common division method. So first 12 and 15. A1 is 12 and 15. So what we'll do, we'll start by 12. Okay, so by 2. 2 6 are 12. Correct, we cannot divide 15 by 2. So we'll bring down 15 as it is. Then we'll do 2 3 is 6. And again, we'll bring down 15 as it is. Now we have 3 and 15, which is divisible by 3. So 3 1s are 3 and 3 5s are 15, right? So now this one will bring down as it is and will do 5 1s are 5. So what is the LCM of 12 and 15 here? You'll multiply these divisors. So 2 to 2 into 3 into 5, which is 60. So LCM of 12 and 15 is 60. Okay? Now, next one, 24 and 32. So first we'll start dividing by 2. 2 12s are 24 and 2 16s are 32. Then again we'll divide by 2. 2 6 are 12 and 2 8s are 16. Then again we'll divide by 2. 2 3s are 6 and 2 4s are 8. This 4 we can further divide by 2. We'll continue division by 2. So this 3 will bring down as it is. Then this will be 2 2s are 4. So now what we'll do, we'll bring down the 3 as it is and 2 1s are 2. Now 3 1s are 3 and this one will bring it down. Okay, so LCM of 24 and 32 will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3, which is 96. So LCM of 24 and 32 is 96. Okay, so that was question B. Now coming to question C, 8, 12 and 16. So here again we'll start dividing by 2. So 2 4s are 8, 2 6s are 12, 2 8s are 16. Then again we'll divide by 2. 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6 and 2 4s are 8. Okay. So we'll continue division by 2. So 2 1s are 2. This 3 will bring down as it is and 2 2s are 4. Okay. Then 2 1s are 2. Then this 3 will bring down as it is. Then again, sorry, this 1 will bring down as it is. Then this is 2 1s are 2. Now we'll divide by 3. So this 1 and this 1 comes down and this is 3 1s are 3. So LCM is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. That is 48. So LCM of 8, 12 and 16 is 48. Alright. Okay, now so for your homework, question 1, do the questions D, E and F. Question 2, do the question D for homework. And question 3, solve D, E and F as a part of your homework. Okay, so complete that and this completes your chapter on multiples and factors. So in the next class, we'll start with a new chapter. Alright, thank you students. I'll see you all in the next class.